إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in 1 week or so, we pray to Allah Almighty that we will be of those who get to witness another Ramadan in our lifetimes. Amen. And as we've mentioned, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Amen. Allah, as we mentioned, that the Sahaba used to prepare for Ramadan 5 months before it would come. Here we are a week away, if we live, and we will see it, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So I wanted us to remind ourselves, though, of a journey. Al-rihla al-mahtuma. The inevitable journey we will all face when we meet death and after it, and what the two paths and the two scenarios are. So you put this at the forefront of your mind from today till next week, through Ramadan, and frankly for the rest of your life. Al-Bara' ibn Azib radiallahu anhu, he reported that he and the other messengers, they went out with Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the graveyard, and the lahd was not dug yet. So they waited for that to be dug. And in the meantime, the Prophet ﷺ, everyone was sitting still. Very, very still and quiet. And the Prophet ﷺ, he took a stick and he was moving it in the ground. And he looked up at the heavens and he looked at the ground. And he looked up at the heavens and he looked at the ground. And he looked up at the heavens and he looked at the ground. And he said to the companion, "Ista'idu billah min adab al-qabr." Thalathan, he told the companions, seek refuge with Allah from the punishment of the grave. 3 times he said it. And then the Prophet ﷺ 3 times said, Allahumma inni a'udha bika min adab al-qabr. Thalathan, he said 3 times, O Allah, I seek refuge with you from the punishment of the grave. This was the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying it himself. And then he continued with a long hadith. But it is a hadith which speaks for itself, with two paths or two scenarios for your soul to go through when it's extracted from your body and when it's returned to your body after your burial. So let us be mindful of these and reflect and always remember that this is the truth, what will happen to us when we leave this world. إِنَّ قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ, he continued, إِنَّ الْعَبْدِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِذَا كَانَ فِي أَنْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَإِقْبَالَ عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَائِكَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ بيض الوجوه كأن وجوههم الشمس معهم كفن من أكفان الجنة وحنوت من حنوت الجنة حتى يجلس منه مد البصر ثم يجيء ملك الموت عليه السلام حتى يجلس عند رأسه فيقول أيتها النفس المطمئنة أخرجي إلى مغفرة من الله ورضوان حتى إذا خرجت روحه صلى عليه كل ملك بين السماء والأرض وكل ملك في السماء وفتحت له أبواب السماء. The hadith continued, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, verily when the believing abd, he's at the point when the believing servant, the believing slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he's at the point of departure from this dunya, from this worldly life, and is about to enter the next life, angels descend from the heavens. Their faces are white like the sun. They carry with them akfan, shrouds, like the sheets, the garments of Jannah. They carry with them hunut, fragrances, musk, from the fragrances of Jannah. They sit away from him, the level or the length of his eyesight. The angel of death arrives, and he sits by his head. And to the believing abd, he says, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ, O good and peaceful soul, depart to Allah's forgiveness and His pleasure. When the believing soul hears this, it departs easily from the body as water drops from the spout of a water skin, and the angel of death takes it. When the soul leaves the body, all of the angels between the heavens and the earth and all of the angels in the heavens, they pronounce salah on him, meaning they ask Allah to forgive him, all of the or her. All of the gates in the heaven, of the heavens open for them. And the guardians of each of the eight gates of Jannah, they ask Allah, let this soul come to Jannah through my gate. When the angel of death, he takes the soul, the other angels do not leave it in the hands of Malik al-Maut for even the blink of an eye. They quickly go and take it, and they shroud it, and they put it in garments from garments of Jannah, and they put scents, fragrances from the fragrances of Jannah. To this applies Allah's words, تُوَفَّتْهُ رَسُولُنَا وَهُمْ لَا يُفَرَّطُونَ. Our messengers, the angels take his soul, and the angels, they never neglect their duty. فَلَا يَمُرُّونَ عَلَى مَلَئٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَ إِلَّا قَالُوا مَا هَذَا الرُّوحُ الطَّيِّبُ فَيَقُولُونَ فُلَانِ بْنُ فُلَانِ بِأَحْسَنِ أَسْمَائِهِ الَّتِي كَانُوا يُسَمُّونَهُ بِهَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حتى ينتهوا بها إلى السماء الدنيا حتى ينتهى به إلى السماء السابعة فيقول الله عز وجل اكتب كتاب عبدي في عليين. The hadith continued. Now this good soul has been taken from the body. From it the soul issues the best scent of musk and that ever existed on the face of the earth. We love what we smell here, but it ain't nothing compared to what is available from Jannah. The angels, they ascend with the soul as they pass by the gatherings of the angels. They ask them, the angels ask the one carrying this soul, what is this good soul? And they will say, he is so and so, the son of so and so, or the daughter of so and so, using the best names that they were referred to in this dunya. When they reach the lowest heaven, they request admission and the gates open for them. And the most elite of the angels, not just the ones who are the regular task, but the most elite of the angels with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from each heaven, they escort him to the next one till he reaches the highest, the seventh heaven. And then Allah says, اكتبوا كتاب عبدي في عليين, write my servant's record in عليين. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وما أدراك ما عليون كتاب مرقوم يشهده المقربون. Allah says what means and what will make you know what is عليون. It is an inscribed register witnessed by those angels nearest to Allah. This is the register for the believers that we ask Allah to inscribe our names on it. فيكتب كتابه في عليين ثم يقال عيدوه إلى الأرض فإني وعدتهم أني منها خلقتهم وفيها أعيدهم ومنها أخرجهم طارة أخرى فيرد إلى الأرض وتعاد روحه في جسده فإنه يسمع خفق نعال أصحابه إذا ولوا عنه مدبرين فيأتيه ملكان شديد الانتهار فيقولان له من ربك فيقول ربي الله فيقولان ما دينك فيقول دين الإسلام فيقولان له ما هذا الرجل الذي بعث فيكم فيقول هو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقولان له وما عملك فيقول قرأت كتاب الله وأمنت به وصدقت فينتهروه فيقول من ربك ما دينك من نبيك وهي آخر فتنة تعرض على المؤمن. The hadith continues. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, thus his records are inscribed in Iliyun, in the register, the inscribed register, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the seventh heavens, seventh heaven. And the angels are told, take this soul back to the earth, because I promise them that from it I create them. Into it I will send them back, and from it I will bring them out again. He is then returned to the earth, and his soul is returned to his physical body, so that he hears the thumping of his companion's shoes as they walk away from his grave. And Allahu A'lam, this is the last thing the one in the grave can hear from the matters of this dunya, the thumping away of the sandals of the feet of his companions as they walk away from his grave. Two angels, severe in reprimand. We know from other hadith, they're named Munkar and Nakir. The two angels that come and question you in the grave, they come to him and they shake him and they sit him up and they ask him, who is your Lord? So he says, my Lord is Allah. They ask him, what is your deen? What is your religion? He says, my religion, my deen is Islam. They sit him up and say, who is the one who was sent to you with the message? They say, huwa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then they ask a question that many of us fail to think about, fail to reflect upon, fail to remember when we are remembering this hadith. And he says, and what was your actions? And he will say, I read the book of Allah. I believed in it. I believed in it and I obeyed it. I read the book of Allah. I believed in it and I obeyed it. They shake him again and again, asking him, who is your Lord? What is your religion? Who is your prophet? Who is your Lord? What is your religion? Who is your prophet? And this is the last fitna to which a believer is subjected to in regards to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يُثَبَّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah says what means that Allah keeps the believers firm with firm words in this life, this first one and the next. فَيَقُولُ ربي الله ودين الإسلام ونبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فينادي مناد في السماء صدق عبدي فأفرشوه من الجنة وألبسوه من الجنة وافتحوا له بابا إلى الجنة فيأتيه من روحها وطيبها ويفسح له في قبره مد بصر ويأتيه رجل حسن الوجوه حسن الثياب طيب الريح فيقول أبشر بالذي يسرك أبشر برضوان من الله وجنات فيها نعيم نعيم مقيم هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد. Then the one in the grave, the believing servant who has passed those questions, he continues to repeat, my Lord is Allah, my deen is Islam, my prophet is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A caller then calls out from the heavens, Sadaqa abdi, my servant has spoken the truth. So provide him with furnishings from Jannah. Clothe him, give him clothing from Jannah, and open for him a door to Jannah. Then he receives the provisions from it. He receives the perfumes from Jannah while he's in his grave. And his grave, what we see to be the small dayiq makan, the small little space, is made expansive to him the length of his eyesight. This is a different life, ya akhwani wa akhwati wa fillah. A different life, the life of the barzakh. Don't just think everything is what you can comprehend or see. So before him appears a man, and he comes to him with a pleasant face, and nice garments, and a good smell. And he says to him, I am to give you glad news that will please you. News of Allah's acceptance and guidance of everlasting bliss. This is the day that you have been promised. فَيَقُولُ لَهُ وَأَنْتَ فَبَشَّرَكَ اللَّهُ بِخَيْرٍ مَنْ أَنْتَ فَوَجْهُكَ الْوَجْهِ يَجِيءُ بِالْخَيْرِ فَيَقُولُ أَنَا عَمَلَكُ الصَّالِحِ فَوَاللَّهِ مَا عَلِمْتَكَ إلا كنت سريعا في طاعة الله وبطيعا في معصية الله فجزاك الله خيرا ثم يفتح له باب من الجنة وباب من النار فيقول هذا منزلك لو عصيت الله أبدلك الله به هذا فإذا رأى ما في الجنة قال ربي عجل قيام الساعة. The hadith continues. So you see in the grave someone coming to you with a pleasant face, saying, "This is the day you've been promised." He responds, "Glad news from Allah be to you. Who are you? Your face is one that brings good." He says, "I am your good deeds." So even the deeds we do, even the deeds we do, these things that to us are abstract, that we can't touch, they will have voice on the day of resurrection. They will have voice in that next life. It says, "I am your good deeds. By Allah, I only knew you quick to obey Allah. You always rush to obey Allah. You were slow to disobey Allah. So may Allah reward you well." A door then is opened for him to Jannah, and another one to the fire. And he's shown the fire. And he said, "This is the fire that you would have been dwelling in if you disobeyed Allah. But Allah substituted for you this Jannah." When he sees what's awaiting for him in Jannah, he can't wait. He starts imploring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, "Oh my Lord, speed up the arrival of the resurrection so I can rejoin my family and property and get to this Jannah." And he's told, "Askun." This is the journey of the good soul. May Allah grant us this as good news. أَقُولُ قَلِي هَذَا صَفْرَ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فَاللَّهِ يَخْسِرْ لَكُمْ ذِنُوبَ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. This long hadith continues. There's two ways to go. There's not 5, 10, 20 directions. You're either taken out as a good soul with glad tidings, or taken out as the soul we're going to see. As Ramadan comes, throughout Ramadan, every day, let us remember this is the inevitable journey our soul will go through. We just don't know which one we're going to be called out with. وَإِنَّ الْعَبْدِ الْكَافِرِ إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَإِقْبَالَ عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ سَوْدُ الْوُجُوهِ مَعَهُمْ الْمَسُوحُ مِنَ النَّارِ فَيَجْلِسُونَ مِنْهُ مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ ثم يجيء ملك الموت عليه السلام حتى يجلس عند رأسه فيقول أيتها النفس الخبيثة أخرجي إلى سخط من الله وغضب فتفرق في جسده فينتزعها كما ينتزع فيلعنه كل ملك بين السماء والأرض وكل ملك في السماء وتغلق أبواب السماء ليس من أهل باب إلا وهم يدعون الله ألا تعرج روحه من قبلهم فيصعدون بها فلا يمرون على ملئ من الملائكة إلا قال ما هذا الروح الخبيث فيقولون فلان بن فلان بأقبح أسمائه التي كان يسمى بها في الدنيا حتى ينتهى بها إلى السماء الدنيا فيستفتح له فلا يفتح له. So this portion of the hadith continues. Then comes the disbelieving servant. In some of the hadith it mentions Fajr, the corrupt one. The one who's corrupt, not necessarily just the believer, but the one who's corrupt. Verily when the disbelieving or the disobedient abd is at the point of departure from the worldly life, and is about to enter the hellfire, strong hulking angels with dark faces descend on him from the heavens. They bring with them tough fabrics from the fabrics of the hellfire. They sit away from him the length of his eyesight. The angel of death arrives and sits by his head and says, O malicious soul, rather than أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّ, O pleased and good soul, now, O malicious soul, depart to a wrath and anger from Allah. On hearing this, he becomes terrified and he clings to the body, and he's extracted by force like a skewer is pulled from wet wool, causing the veins and the nerves to burst. Every angel in the heavens and the earth, and every angel in the heavens curses him. The gates of the heaven are shut. The guardians of every gate implore Allah Do not let this soul come near my gate. Do not let them come near here. When the angel of death takes the soul, the other angels do not leave it with him for the blink of an eye. They put it in a tough fabric, and from it emanates the most pungent, disgusting smell that you can ever think of. The angels then ascend with it. As they pass by the gatherings of the angels, they say, "What is this malicious soul?" So they respond, "He is so-and-so, the son of so-and-so," using the worst names with which he was addressed in the first life. When they reach the lowest heaven, they request admission, but the gates are not opened for him. فيقول الله عز وجل اكتبوا كتابه في سجين في الأرض السفلى ثم يقال أعيدوا عبدي إلى الأرض فإني وعدتهم أني منها خلقتهم وفيها أعيدهم ومنها أخرجهم تارة أخرى. Allah says, for this malicious soul, write his record fi sijjin. Write it in sijjin, a place that is most low, a place of imprisonment, in the lowest earth. And they are told, take him back to the earth, because I promised all of them that from them I created it. Into the earth I will send them back, and from it I will resurrect them again. And his soul is then cast down from the heavens without regard. Not placed nicely like the good soul. It's just dropped back into the body, and it falls into the body. فتعاد روحه في جسده فإنه ليسمع حفق نعال أصحابه إذا ولوا عنه ويأتيه ملكان شديد الانتهار فينتهرانه ويجلسانه فيقولان له من ربك فيقول ها لا أدري فيقولان له ما دينك فيقول ها لا أدري فيقولان له من هذا الرجل الذي بعث فيكم فلا يهتدي لاسمه فيقال محمد فيقول ها لا أدري سمعت الناس يقولون ذاك فيقال لا ضريت ولا تلوت فينادي مناد من السماء كذب فأفرشوا له من النار وافتحوا له بابا إلى النار ويأتيه رجل قبيح الوجه قبيح الثياب منتن الريح فيقول أبشر بالذي يسوءك هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد فيقول وأنت فبشرك الله الخبيث فوالله ما علمت فبشرك الله الخبيث من أنت فوجهك الوجه يجيء بالشر فيقول أنا عملك الخبيث فوالله ما علمت إلا كنت بطيئا في طاعة الله سريعا إلى معصية الله فجزاك الله شرا. The hadith concludes, as the Prophet ﷺ, he says, then the soul is restored to the body, so that it hears the thumping away of its companion's feet that just buried him. Two angels, Munkir and Nakir, severe and reprimand, come and they sit him up in his grave. And they say, who is your Lord? And he says, ha, la adri. He says, alas, this is like saying, someone who says this is in a state of concern, in a state of worry, in a state of pity and grief. He says, I do not know. They ask him, what is your religion? He says the same thing. La adri, I don't know. When it was asked, who was the one who was sent to you? He says, for a second, I cannot recall his name. So he's told his name is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he says, alas, I don't know. I just heard the people talking about him or saying that. He is then told, you did not know, and you did not recite the Quran. And a caller calls from the heavens, this is a liar. So spread for him furnishings from the fire, and open for him a door from the fire. And then the heat and fierce wind will reach him, and his grave will be tightened, causing his ribs to break. Before him will come a man with an ugly face, repulsive in clothes, smelling foul and disgusting, and he'll say, I'm giving you evil news that will displease you. This is the day you were promised. He responds, evil news from Allah be to you. Who are you? Your face is one that brings evil. So he will say, I am your malicious deeds. I am your evil deeds by Allah. I only knew you slow to obeying Allah, fast to disobeying Allah. So may Allah repay you with evil. So a door is opened for him to the fire, and he's given from the fire's furnishings. He then says, Oh my Lord, do not establish the hour. Rabbi la tuqim as-sa'a. He says, Oh my Lord, do not let the hour come, because he knows his destination. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, what ending do you want? What ending do you seek for yourself? What ending do you want for your family, for your children? How do you want their soul extracted from their body, gently or roughly? How do you want the soul returned to their body when they're buried, gently or just dropping out of the sky? How will you answer the questions of the grave? How will you answer when you're asked, Man Rabbuk, who is your Lord? Will we be able to say, Rabbi Allah, if we didn't worship Him correctly, if we didn't know who He was, if our tawheed and aqeedah was not straight, and we didn't give about that aspect of Islam? How will you answer when you're asked, Ma deenuk, what is your religion? If you didn't live upon Islam, how can you lie and say Islam? It will be said, Sadaqa abdi aw kadhaba. It will be said, my slave has spoken the truth or he's lied. You ain't going to be able to fool Allah. How will you answer when you're asked, what is your deen? How will you answer when you're asked, who is the one who was sent to you? Who is your prophet? How can you answer Muhammad ﷺ if you desert his sunnah? If you choose what someone today says over what he or his companion said or did? When he said that success, being from the successful group, that Islam would spread into 73, he said, مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمُ أَصْحَابِي, that the correct one, the saved one, the people who will go to Jannah, will be the ones who are upon what I'm upon and what my companions are upon. If you're not upon this, how can you answer? It's just like someone being given a question on a test in chemistry, and all they ever studied was English. If you did not do it, you will not be able to lie on that day. How will you answer? Rasulullah ﷺ, al-uswat al-hasana, the best example to mankind, and his sunnah is treated like garbage. Because my culture is more important. Where I came from is more important. How I did it my whole life is more important. How they pray in my country is more important. This is what we follow, this is what we come to. How will it be? How can we say, Huwa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we don't follow him as our example and take his sunnah? You know the reward you get if you did something for 50 years and you say all of a sudden, I've been doing it wrong, and you do it the right way, you'll get reward upon reward. Get rid of your pride and your ego. Follow the sunnah of the best of mankind, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Will you be able to answer when you're asked, وَمَا عَمَلُكَ, and what were your actions, what were your deeds? Will you be able to say, قَرَأْتُ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, I read the book of Allah, وَأَمَنْتُ بِهِ, and I believed in it, وَصَدَّقْتُ, and I implemented it? Will you be able to say that? If you deserted the book of Allah, if it was just in your home because you thought that's what brings you protection, because this is the jahil, the ignorance nowadays. You move into a home, you want to do a khatam for the home, and there's no place in the sunnah for that. And then the Quran is never read in that home. وَمَا عَمِلُكَ, what are your actions? You will be asked that. So in the grave, قَرَأْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, I read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What if you're not reading it? أَمَنْتُ بِي, I believed in it. Okay, we say we believe in it. وَصَدَّقْتُ, and I implemented it. I put it to practice. How if you're not doing it? How? Will your barzakh life then be one of shrouds and perfumes of Jannah, where good angels meet you, talking to you about being a good soul? Or will it be ones where you have shrouds from the hellfire that are harsh and rough and will cut your skin? Where you have you have a scent, a fragrance that will be disgusting and foul? What do you want for your barzakh? What do you want for your next life? What do you want for the day of meeting your Lord? Reflect on these today. Reflect upon them the next week. Reflect on Ramadan them through Ramadan, so that your life is lived knowing that your soul will go through one of these two journeys. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who are the righteous souls, the good souls that are taken out and respond to Allah. Allah's call, that get his mercy and his pleasure, not his anger and his wrath. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there's just a couple quick announcements, inshaAllah. There are some books that are very authentic in knowledge, the relationship with Quran during Ramadan, dua that is not rejected, and a book by Shaykh Saleh Al-Fawzan, Habibullah, about the ahadith, about fasting, its rulings and its manners. They're free for you to take. They're on the outside of the masjid, so you can take them, inshaAllah, read them and benefit them as the month of Ramadan approaches. May Allah allow us to see it. We have some dates for sale. We have some dates for sale. The box is $45, 11 pounds. Even if you think you can't take half of it, if you think you only go through half, give the other half away. And yani, encourage that charity from now, so the people can break the fast with something you purchase for them, bi-idhnillah. They're going to be in the social hall because it's warm outside. So purchase that box today, inshaAllah, in the social hall after the salah. Lastly, there is a sign-up sheet for WhatsApp or email addresses. If you're not getting the WhatsApp messages from the community or the emails, we're going to be announcing stuff about the iftar program during Ramadan. We're trying to do a kids iftar program on a separate day just for the youth, inshaAllah. So this is in the plans. We will need some brothers or sisters to sponsor some of this. We'll be getting those messages out. Check your WhatsApp messages. I know they may come to you sometimes. Look at them. You may be missing something valuable, inshaAllah. So these things will be coming out soon. So if you're not getting them and you want to receive them, the sign-up sheet is on the way out. And we have the iPads in the back available for donation, inshaAllah, or for the date purchases, for you to, if you only have a credit card, to use for them, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات أحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.